Good evening. I'm Justin Sane, and I'd like to say hello to all of my friends out there in TV land. Hey, crazies. Welcome to another episode of the Lizards of Wisdom TV show. This evening, we're out here at Cal State University Northridge for the Video Jam 99 screenings and awards ceremony. We're going to be cruising around, hopefully getting to interview a few of these wild and crazy artists, get their insights on what the in thing is right now, what's going on, what's going down, what's happening. And then we're also gonna be looking for Mr. Jack Reilly, the professor of art and video animation. And he's also the master of ceremonies hosting this whole thing tonight. So what do you say we go find Jack and talk to him?
Hey, we found him.
Howdy.
Doug, 3, 2.
Hey, what have I always been telling you cats out there in TV land? This is cool stuff. We said we were going to go look for Jack, and we have found Mr. Reilly, and check this out. We're already inside the CSUN Little Theater, and we're just about to get things rolling here. So, Jack, tell us what's going on here tonight.
All right. Well, this is Video Jam 1999. This is the 8th year we've done this program, and it's an exhibition of student works. We cover everything from computer animation, digital video, some live action, experimental, visual effects, traditional animation. I think that pretty much covers it.
Sounds like it's going to be a great night. I've been to a number of animation festivals myself, and everyone that I've been to, there's just some awesome artists out there producing some of the craziest stuff, some of the most experimental stuff, the newest stuff, everything that's happening on the cutting edge, and I'm sure you've got a lot of those students in your classes.
Yeah, definitely. We've got some real edgy stuff out here. Most of it is experimental in nature. Some of it is brand new. I mean, the work is brand new. It's like some of it was just finished this week. It comes from students who have ranged from beginners to people who have been here for quite a while. So it's a great show. You're going to love it, guaranteed.
All right, we're looking forward to it. Let's go check it out.
I've got two over here.
freshness of the soil comes spinning like a thunder straight from the floor, trumpets are blurring, the clams coming round, so the clear to plain as well.
Love is the only weapon.
Love is the only weapon with which I got to fight. I got a hell of a lot of weapons to fight. I got my claws. I got compasses. I got guns. I got dynamite. I got a hell of a lot to fight. I'll fight. I'll fight.
Long you normally live? You may be 1, 2, maybe 3 weeks old.
This is Dick. What's up?
Hey, do you have Dr. Pepper in a can?
Actually, yeah, I do.
Yeah? Well, you better let him out.
Bloody hell, you could have at least given me a magazine, cheeky bugger.
Weekend on the E! True Hollywood Story. He was one of the world's most beloved cartoon characters.
Here I come to save the day. That means the Mighty Mouse is on the way. Yes, sir, when there is a wrong to right.
But for Mighty Mouse, being a cartoon character just wasn't enough.
There is a massive dream of being one of the world.
Her life's ambition was to be a star.
When I first showed up on the scene, you know, it's nobody took me seriously. You know, it's like because I'm a mouse, I'm not a real superhero or something. Just bullshit.
In any case, I met him at a comic book convention, and he got livid with me when I tried to talk to him. You know, here I am, stooping to his level to talk to him, and he just got angry. Very, very angry.
I don't know what the big deal is about the guy anyway, really. I mean, you know, he doesn't even have any powers, you know? He's got a ring. So it's just a ring.
He was telling me, you're not a real superhero. Look at me, I've got a cape, I'm a real superhero. Somebody just gave you that ring. Yeah, like, it's real easy to get into the core. Somebody just gives you a ring.
I've been here for, you know, probably, you know, about as long as he has. You know, and yeah, you know, all the power to him, but I think I deserve a little bit more respect.
That guy is jealous. He's jealous and he's petty. And that's why I hate that son of a bitch. All he does is complain, oh, you're not a real superhero. You just got that ring. Yeah, buddy, you think I just got this ring? You think I just got this in an alley? You think I found this as I was fiddling through my f***ing Cracker Jacks? Bullshit. You're a little rodent wearing a cape. You're nothing. You're horseshit. That's what I want to tell you, Mighty Mouse. I hope you're watching this right now. F*** you. Not a real superhero, my ass. I earn this, alright? It takes dedication, willpower, courage, and the world's biggest c*** to wield this ring. You have none of those. F*** off, Mouse Boy.
He yearned to be a real superhero.
Dark Might, okay, That was at a low point in my career, you know, I wasn't doing much. I was still reeling from being the happy, funny, cartoony mouse guy from my show. You know, so I was trying to pull myself away from that. I wanted to darken my image, you know, so people would take me seriously as a serious superhero. I'm a superhero. Not a cartoon character.
He's on a cartoon. A toon show. He plays up for kids. He's not a superhero.
But his struggle for acceptance and individuality would lead him down a road of boobs, drugs, prostitutes, and twisted love triangles.
I've heard some things. I got an email the other day that possibly it's a love tryst. Green Lantern had a crush on Mighty Mouse, and a thing started between them, so I've heard.
You know, that's not my thing. I don't fly that way. I don't know if there's anything wrong with that.
The only thing I've ever come close to a gay love affair was the Martian Manhunter. He turned into a girl, and I was a little wasted.
He numbed the pain of his self-loathing with food, drugs, alcohol, and sex.
Hey, Mighty Mouse, there he is. Mighty Mouse,
get the thing out of here. Hey, turn that off.
I just want to get a minute. I just want to ask you a couple questions. Come on, Mighty, come on. Maybe we can follow him. Maybe we can get something out of him.
Turn the thing off. Just get a couple of words.
Okay, look, I was just giving her a ride, okay? And I didn't know she was a guy. You know, I thought she was just, you know, a normal female prostitute. But I wasn't soliciting. You know, it was just to help her out, you know?
Watch as we follow this famous mouse through his meteoric rise and devastating fall from grace.
Hey! Yeah, run that stuff, man.
You know, it's been about 35 years since my first show, and, you know, not a day goes by that some jackass doesn't call me Mickey. I mean, I don't even know what it is, you know, I don't even look like that guy.
He looks exactly like Mickey Mouse. There was no variation whatsoever.
I was gonna do a new show, Mighty Morphin Mouse, but, you know, we started getting going on that, and, you know, they made a few changes. I had to sell the rights to that, but, you know, they changed it around a little bit. It was, you know, some powery karate people instead they wanted to use instead of me. And they, you know, it was a few more, but it was basically the same idea. You know, that was my idea.
Hear from those he aspired to be, but was instead rejected by.
Well, one time I was fighting some parademons in Coast City, and it was getting a little crazy, and I needed some help, and Mighty Mouse came, and he helped me. We fought them off. It was great. And then, you know, afterwards he asked me to dinner. I thought, well, it's the least I could do, let him take me to dinner. But then afterwards, you know, he expected sex, and he tried to grab my ass. You know, I couldn't believe it.
She couldn't keep her hands off of me. She still can. I mean, you know, we had to break it off, but, you know, she still calls me. You know, she comes over to my pad, you know, mouse pad, and you know, she's all over me, but you know, she's just, yeah, I guess I'm just too much man for her.
Well, you know, then he was like, hey, you know, let's go back to my place. He starts trying to feel me up, you know, and wants me to tie him up with my lasso. I'm like, back off, mouse, you dirty rat, get away from me.
You know, so I have to tell her, you know, back off, girl, you know. It's like, I got a girlfriend now, you know, moving on, you know, get on with your life.
This is the story of a mouse who, despite his great might, could never find the power to love himself.
Look, I told you I don't do that shit anymore.
Mighty Mouse, Sunday at 8 on the E! True Hollywood Story.
There was a massive dream of being one of the world's
her life's ambition was to be a star.
Okay, you hear me, you goddamn rat?
Okay, anyway, for the first award, we have a new award now. It's called the Lifetime Achievement Award. This award is given to the student who graduates and goes on to do something. We have many of those. We have our students working in major studios. We have them going into MFA programs elsewhere. And sometimes here we have a new MFA in the area. And we have them being artists and all kinds of things. But the Lifetime Achievement Award goes to, you remember the first piece, A Pale Horse? Goes to Michael Laughlin. Michael graduated last spring, and he's now working as a professor, and he doesn't even have an MA yet, as a professor at Moorpark College and at Brooks College in Long Beach, and also he is he works at E! Entertainment TV. Right. And so anyway, let's give a round of applause for Michael. I won some past video games. Do you have anything to say?
I'd like to thank my beautiful wife.
Are you married? Congratulations. And the third place award goes to Ann Geyer for Small Wonder. That was the butterfly and girl piece. Thank you. And Ann is also, she also did the one near the end with the butterfly. She likes butterflies. Would you like to make a statement of any sort?
No.
No, thank you. Okay, I'll make it on behalf of Ann. Thank you very much. Second place award for second place overall goes to Ray Seibels for Incantation. Okay. That was the piece that had the dragon and the medieval guy and so on. Do you have any statement you'd like to make?
Everybody who made me laugh this semester, I love you guys.
Okay, she loves you. First place goes to Mitchell Roche for Hollywood Story. He also made the piece Crank, the second animation you saw with the guy on the phone. Mitchell is also the president of Vinimation now, which has nothing to do with him getting the award. Just coincidence. Often these achievers tend to take on many things at one time. And he got all the bagels and also helped, you know, help produce this program. Would you like to make a statement?
Sure, I'll chat. Should I hold this? I will thank some people. I'll thank my my parents for their endless support, financial and otherwise. My pal and co-producer Taylor Johns. All my other friends who generously lent me their time for a small bribe. And Jack Reilly and everyone in the Vinimation staff who helped put this together. That's all.
Thank you. He's a very interesting guy. He wanted to redo the piece last night, he called me. He had something was wrong, and he wanted to do it. He put a new version in. I said, no way. I edited that tape for 12 hours. Do you believe that, to get all those pieces together? Anyway, that's it, and I want to thank you. The winners stick around. The press wants to interview you. And I want to thank all of you for coming. I hope you enjoyed the show, and the students worked very hard.